Reliance Industries Limited has just released its third quarter results. To get a better grip on them, we have with us Mr. Alok Agarwal, the CFO of the company. Mr. Agarwal, these results have been keenly debated due to falling oil prices. Can you help us get a better grip on this?
I think the first place to start when we look at our results for this quarter is that we take on board the unprecedented volatility that we have seen in crude prices in this quarter. In just 90 days, crude prices dropped from $90 to roughly $50, about 45% decline in one quarter, which is unprecedented except for the quarter following the global financial crisis. Our revenue, therefore, is down by roughly 20%, which really reflects an average decline through the quarter, starting point to end point of about 40% in crude prices. Most of the company's products in refining and petrochemicals, and of course in E&P, closely track crude prices. So the decline in revenue should be seen in that context. Having said that, on a 9-month basis, we did have a very good period, and we do have record PBIT for 9 months, as can be seen from our results. This quarter, along with the high volatility in crude prices, we also saw a lot of nervousness seep into some of our product markets. Let me first talk about our overall impact of crude on our business. As you know, we produce oil and condensate both in India as well as in the US. These businesses are directly related to the price of oil. On the other hand, because a lot of the energy that we consume is linked to oil prices, and because our refinery processes crude, in which the fuel and loss component is related to oil prices, net-net, we have a marginally beneficial impact of lower crude oil prices on our overall financial performance. Having said that, a large drop in crude prices does work its way through inventory and its associated impact. So when we see gross refining margin at $7.3 a barrel, which is at a lower premium to Singapore complex that we saw in the previous quarter, it masks what was underlying a very good operational performance. Each of the major product cracks were better than previous quarter. Light heavy differentials were roughly at the same level, and we had near record throughput. What took some of that away was really the effect of inventory working its way through the financials as prices dropped during the quarter. All in all, we are still very happy with our performance during this quarter. The things that we did to make sure that the impact of falling crude prices was mitigated to some extent, we really worked closely with our buyers to make sure that we could, particularly our term buyers, to make sure that we could place our product well, and work constructively with suppliers of crude who were supplying into a very long and soft market. As we think about product cracks, this quarter has started well. We still see, despite falling prices in crude, we still see product cracks holding up due to the lag effect. And as of now, even Singapore complex is not very different from what it was in the previous quarter. Moving on to our petrochemical business, that is really a combination of our cracking business, which is our olefins chain, our aromatics business, which is really around paraxylene and PTA, and our downstream polyester business. In two out of those three businesses, we saw very healthy margins. In our naphtha cracking business, we saw margins which were well above 5-year averages and between 15% to 40%, depending on the product, higher than the previous quarter. In our downstream polyester business, margins again expanded over the previous quarter, and even though there was destocking, we were able to place all our production well into the markets. Our third business, which is aromatics, as I said, PTA and paraxylene, had a different dynamic. In both these products, we have had significant capacity additions in the last 18 months, and that overhang of capacity is still impacting margins in those businesses. We think that over a period of time, as operating rates go up, we should see better margins in that particular segment. Having said all that, it's also fair to say that we were unable to realize the full benefit of better deltas and margins, as while our customers were destocking, we were providing them with a pricing environment which was conducive to their own margin and their own consumption. So this we see every time when prices go down much more than anticipated, that you really don't get the full benefit of what we see as international deltas, because we have to also work constructively with our customers at the same time. As far as our oil and gas business is concerned, we saw growth in production in our US shale gas business, and in KG-D6, the production remained nearly steady, and that segment was impacted to the extent of just the falling oil prices. If I move away from our hydrocarbon businesses, our retail business again surprised us by doing better than expected. We are now seeing 19% year-on-year growth in terms of revenue. We are now adding between 250 to 300 stores and are now present across the country in over 160 cities. Overall, I think as we look back at the quarter, I do want to re-emphasize that this was a tough quarter. In the commodity business, this kind of volatility really leads to a lot of challenges in terms of making sure that margins get preserved. I think we are quite pleased when we look back at the quarter, as that we have been able to keep our inventories at a low level. We have done very proactive risk management to cushion the impact of falling crude and product prices, and have ended up with what I would say is a very, very satisfactory performance. As we look ahead, the volatility and nervousness in the market is still there. We are cautiously optimistic about this quarter. We do have among the lowest cost positions in all our businesses in the world, and we think that even in volatile market conditions, we will continue to have among the best margins within the industry. Thank you.